viewers, myself Shivanand Bhatt, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Botany, Government Arts and Science College, Karwar. Now I will demonstrate air layering technique, method of inducing roots on the branches when that branch is still there on the mother plant is called layering. There are two types of layerings. One is air layering and another is ground layering. When the layering is performed above the ground level, then that is called air layering. Materials required to conduct this experiment are polythene sheet. Size of the sheet is 20 into 25 centimeters. Grafting sequature. Knife is required. Scissor. Thread. Cello tape. Rooting medium. Pot with rooting medium, but this is required after 3 to 4 weeks of the experiment. Important material required to conduct this experiment is a healthy plant. So for this demonstration, I will take this croton. Scientific name is Codiaeum variegatum of family Euphorbiaceae. Next part is a procedure. Select a healthy branch. So I will use this branch for my demonstration. Then take a knife. Then I will select this portion for layering. Now take a superficial transverse cut in one particular point like this. Then again take a transverse cut or transverse superficial cut here. The distance between the upper cut and the lower is approximately 1.5 to 2 centimeters. After taking these two cuts, take a slit here like this. Take a longitudinal cut between the two transverse cuts. Then slowly remove a ring of bark like this. Just lift it, it will come. This is called girdling. So a ring of bark is removed in a particular region of the stem. Next, take a polythene sheet. This is cello tape. Just stick it in one margin of the polythene sheet like this. Trim it on both sides. Insert it like this. Now it's ready. And then take a thread and tie it at the base. Okay, next, take a rooting medium. This rooting medium comprises cow dung, sawdust, and soil. Cow dung is acting as a fertilizer. Sawdust will increase the moisture, and major component in this medium is soil. So take this rooting medium and apply it over the region where the ring of bark is completely removed. So like this we have to fix this rooting medium. Then just lift this pouch with the help of thread, tie it like this. So these leaves in the branch will show photosynthesis. Due to photosynthesis, food is synthesized. A food which is synthesized will move in downward direction through the phloem, but here a ring of bark is removed, but that bark region which comprises phloem. Because this is a dicot plant, in dicot the vascular bundle is conjoint collateral open type. So phloem is in the peripheral part, therefore that phloem is removed. So during the movement of food particle, here there is no phloem, therefore it gets accumulated. Slowly that region will expand or it will enlarge. Because of the presence of rooting media in that region, it will produce numerous roots. So after the development of roots, cut it and plant it. Previously I have done air layering in another branch. So I will show this with the help of sequencer. I will cut it. Observe this branch. Here region we can see plenty of adventitious roots. Just remove the polythene sheet and thread which is there around the adventitious roots. See, these are the adventitious roots. Now this is a branch with adventitious roots. When we plant it, definitely it will grow into an independent functional plant. Take this pot and plant it in this like this. Cover it with rooting medium. Now this is a potted plant. So by using air layering technique, we can get the plants of equal size, and rate of success in layering is always 100%. Whereas in cutting, when we remove the branch and if it is planted, rate of success is very less. Therefore, you can practice it in your garden. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.